Well, we're once again making meals with Marcus Restaurants. And joining us today is Chef Brian Frakes, the executive chef at the Hilton Milwaukee. And this morning, because obviously Monday is Valentine's Day.
It's a big day, yeah.
It's a big day for a lot of people.
Yeah.
What are we making for the people at home?
We have a table loaded with aphrodisiacs here. In the spirit of the holiday, our flagship restaurant, the Milwaukee Chop House, we're featuring Eat Something Sexy menus for Valentine's Day. So I wanted to show you a couple of aphrodisiac items we're doing there. So I'll get that started and answer any questions you might have.
All right. So it's not a myth. I mean, there really are foods that sort of
absolutely
give you that feeling.
We did some research, and basically, seriously, everything here is an aphrodisiac.
And we're starting with tuna. Okay.
Nice, silky, sexy fish. This is yellowfin sushi grade tuna.
What do you season it with? Just some of your special seasoning?
That's our special seasoning we use in the Chop House. Yes.
So,
Yeah, no, I can't tell you. So here we've created what's really cool, an absinthe peach vinaigrette, both strong aphrodisiacs, so be very careful.
You like your absinthe, don't you?
I do. I just think it's a fun ingredient to play with.
Sure.
Some figs, which are obviously an ancient aphrodisiac. Celery leaves. I'm creating a salad that we're going to put with the tuna here.
Okay.
Let me just keep that moving.
Now, the technique that you're doing with the tuna here.
It's called the tiger's eye. It's just a quick, like, 30-second sear on all the sides, so when they cut into it, it looks like a tiger's eye. It's a kind of a Hawaiian tradition. A little basil. Very strong aphrodisiac for the libido, or so they say. almonds. It's really cool salad here. A little bit more of the peach absinthe vinaigrette, and then we'll lay some down on the plate as well. And then I'll cut some of this tuna.
All right. Let's show the camera here what it looks like a bit when you put that down. So you just kind of put that down as the base for your tuna?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
A little bit of the spiced apple chips we made this morning. Apple, Adam and Eve, take a bite of the apple. it's loaded with them. A little bit of the tuna here. And this is an awesome appetizer. Again, available in the Milwaukee
Chop
House.
It looks like it could be a whole meal, though.
Yeah. and then a celery oil just to kind of go with the celery leaves.
Okay. Now, for people at home, will they be able to find some of these ingredients at the store?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. Celery, this is just literally the leaves off a stalk of celery.
Okay.
You can just pick them. And, people pay all this money for these fancy microgreens. You have them on your celery in your refrigerator.
Okay.
dried figs. Figs are beautiful. And go well with the nice, silky, fresh, sushi-grade tuna.
Very sexy. All right, well, we'll be doing something else that you want to keep it right here because the next one is a dessert. It's going to be delicious. Now, for this recipe, though, you can go to our website, wisn.com. Again, we'll have much more with Chef Brian Frakes coming up a little bit later.